Hello, everybody. Ohio Rail Fan Productions here, and this is episode 1 of History of Famous Locomotives. Now, this is kind of a take on of Amtrak I-365's engines of Amtrak's and Thunderbolt 1000 Siren Productions engines of SEPTA. Now, I'm not doing certain railroads. I'm doing certain locomotives that most rail fans know about and that are pretty popular. So today we are doing Southern Railway 3170, and the next one will be a restored chassis system locomotive. So I hope you enjoy this. It took a while to make, and enjoy the video. And now for some general info about Southern 3170. It was built by the Electric Motive Division of General Motors in April 1971. 3170 was the first of 159 SD40 and SD40 units acquired by the Southern Railway. It served for nearly 40 years before being retired. 3170 is believed to be one of only four SD40 locomotives preserved out of approximately 1,268 built. Southern Railway 3170 has a V16 diesel and an EMD 16-645-E3 prime mover. It produces a maximum of 3,000 horsepower and a maximum speed of 83 miles an hour. Southern Railway 3170 has a Nathan P5 horn. Here are some samples. Back in 2015, Norfolk Southern made a staggering announcement that they were returning the 3170 and repainting it into the Southern Railway Tuxedo Scheme. It served a one-year life on Norfolk Southern before being donated to the TVRM. There, it did such jobs as photo charters, and it was the diesel escort for the 21st Century Steam Program. As you may know, Southern 3170 is a high hood and built for long and forward operation. Now, Southern Railway and Norfolk and Western Railway did certain precautions for the train crews, because if you were to hit a car or a truck running long and forward, there would be no injuries in the cab, and that's for short hood too, because you'd have the high hood. Most of Southern Railway and Norfolk and Western Railway's locomotives were built for long and forward operation. Norfolk and Westerns were built for dual because they had dual control stands, but most of Southerns were just straight long hood control stands. The reason Southern and NNW did this was just for crew safety, and but it did have some backlash because visibility is kind of low, but it still did save the crew's lives, so that is a good thing. Southern Railway 3170 has truly had an incredible life. From taking on the Salutograde in the 1970s to being the diesel escort of the 21st Century Steam Program, 3170 may not run today, but it still remains as a true survivor of the Southern Railway. Now, I want to thank each and every one of you for watching this video, and stay tuned for episode 2, where we cover chassis system 8272. Thank you for watching. Please remember to like and subscribe. And if you really liked it, you can, you know, show a friend. And thanks again for watching. This is Ohio Rail Fan Productions, out.